Hi guys, I'm Catrin, nice to meet you. I feel very honored to be part of this meeting today. I'm a HUPS member since 1 year now, and thanks Dennis for inviting me. I'm living together with my friend Didi in the northern area of Austria, not far away from the Czech border. We both are happily retired already. We have been teachers, and therefore we had the great opportunity to go on travel with our backpacks each year for 2 months in different regions of our planet. We always tried to avoid the touristic spots, tried to travel off the beaten path, explore new locations, get in touch with the locals and with their way of living. We snorkeled a lot, but we started scuba diving pretty late in 2007 on a place called Pichler Islands in the northeastern coast of Malaysia. And that definitely was a game changer. From this point on, all our further journeys led us to the ocean side. But we kept our backpacking travel style. We still love to explore new locations. We're always looking for small local dive shops to support the locals and to avoid group diving. We love to dive really, really slowly and to observe the behavior of the animals. And I keep my camera gear as lightweight and small as possible. Therefore, I still dive with a compact camera. And I use a strong video light and wet lenses. That gives me the opportunity to shoot a wide angle and macro on one dive. And I can keep on shooting still when the conditions get rough and the current starts ripping, which often is the case in our favorite country for diving, Indonesia. And Indonesia is exactly the place I want to show you in my video. I want to introduce you to three different destinations, which are not necessarily on the list of most scuba divers. The first destination is situated in Kalimantan, the Derawan Archipelago. Kalimantan is the Indonesian part of the island Borneo. It's a beautiful place, and three islands are especially good for diving. Derawan itself is a turtle nesting ground, and with each high tide, they come in for grazing in the shallow waters. And the locals sometimes they hang banana leaves into the water and they feed on this. Sangalaki is a manta territory. Kakaban is wall diving, and it has a really beautiful jellyfish lake in the middle of the small island, which is surrounded by a tropical rainforest, a stunning place. Maratua has a beautiful lagoon, and it's known for its currents. Therefore, it's big fish country and has big schools of barracudas. For the second destination, we are heading to the southwest of Sulawesi, a place called Tanabaru. The region there is known for the tradition of building the bugi or pinisi boats. When you have been on a liveaboard in Indonesia already, you might know these beautiful, huge wooden boats. And it's really stunning to watch the locals building these boats, because most of the construction work is still carried out by hands with traditional equipment. Not far away from Tanabaru is the beach town Bira. Bira has beautiful stretched out beaches where the locals are gathering on weekends with their families. And some nice diving too, especially in the summertime when the currents are strong and the waves are strong, you can meet a lot of sharks there. Mostly reef sharks, black tips, white tips, some grays. And when we have been there, we have been extremely lucky and had a really nice encounter with a tiger shark who came straight up the wall to check us out. third destination is in the middle of Sulawesi. There is a city called Gorontalo, which is actually a hub for the travelers and backpackers on their way to the Togian Islands. But we decided to spend some days there because they have a sponge there, which you can't find elsewhere in Indonesia, the Salvador Dali sponge, which has his name from the strange structure and patterns. Gorontalo has good wall diving and one really excellent muck dive site in front of a small village. And we met there on one single dive more than 10 juvenile hairy frog fishes and a lot of other cool critters. From Gorontalo, we then took the night ferry to Togian Islands, to the island of Una Una. Una Una has only one village, about 200 people living there. And due to a volcanic eruption in the 80s, the island was uninhabited for many, many years. That protected it from the dynamite fishing, which is still pretty common in the other islands of the Togians. But Una Una has really beautiful untouched reefs, many fishes, some strange hard coral formations, and one dive site with a huge school of barracudas. So that was it. I think enough said now. I hope you enjoy my film.
whiskey, steps everywhere, knives in his pockets and bullets in his hair. He has nothing to live for, nothing left to say. He's locking all the doors to keep the only wolves at bay.